Hello my friends, in today's video we will take a look at the best action, pocket and compact cameras that you can buy in late 2021. There have been some very interesting releases in this category in the past couple of months, so there will be a lot of changes in comparison to the previous list. For the purposes of this list, I have defined this category as cameras that have sensors smaller than 1 inch and can fit into a pocket. We will start with the original, which is the GoPro and their Hero 10 Black. Hero 10 Black seems to be a mild upgrade over Hero 9, but those changes make a big difference in the real-world use. First of all, it shoots very nice action camera footage. Especially the dynamic range was significantly improved. 5.3K video captures an exceptional amount of detail. It can shoot 4K up to 120p, which is also important because you don't have to upscale the slow-mo footage. Hypersmooth stabilization works great as expected, but there isn't a huge upgrade over Hero 9 in that regard. GP2 processor made the whole operation much faster and more responsive, and it also vastly improved the reliability. I haven't experienced a single freeze yet, which definitely wasn't the case with Hero 9. Hero 10 is also very rugged and durable. I think that GoPro doesn't get enough credit for that. Probably the biggest criticism of Hero 10 was the overheating, which was a real thing, but it was significantly improved by the firmware update. I can say that GoPro Hero 10 is a very good action camera, it doesn't really have any major weaknesses after the firmware update, so I can highly recommend it. The second camera on the list is DJI Action 2. This is a new innovative concept of semi-modular camera. Action 2 is incredibly small, but it still uses a relatively large 1 over 1.7-inch sensor and ultra-wide lens. The output is now very good. It also got a significant firmware update, which improved the dynamic range and automatic exposure. It shoots 4K video, but the amount of detail is very high due to the large sensor. The field of view on Action 2 is wider than on the GoPro, but it isn't too wide for all-round use. I also really like the colors. Rocksteady stabilization is among the best on the market. The second part of the Action 2 is the display module or power module. That one contains the SD card slot, USB-C port, larger 1300mAh battery and 3 more microphones. Also worth mentioning is that both screens are very high resolution 350 pixel per inch OLED screens and they look great. There was some overheating drama with Action 2 as well, but I haven't experienced that at all. I got over 80 minutes of recording at room temperature with absolutely no issues, so I can't really comment on that. Action 2 is a little bit misunderstood. Some people want the SD card slot, larger battery, charging port and so on the main unit, which is completely fine because they can already have all of that with GoPro Hero 10. Action 2 is meant for those who can take advantage of that very small form factor and versatility. I'm a huge fan of this concept and I really like to use the Action 2. I actually like it as much as the DJI Pocket 2, which is the next camera on my list. I've been using Pocket 2 for about a year now and it is still one of my most favorite cameras of any type. The main reason for that is that the combination of a gimbal, 20mm equivalent focal length and excellent 4K video just works. The footage still looks distinctively better and more natural than the usual action camera footage. Pocket 2 uses a quite large 1 over 1.7-inch sensor, which is definitely nice to see. As I've explained before, DJI was able to get the video processing right, so the high-resolution sensor has no negative impact on the image quality. The video is very detailed and it looks great overall, including the colors. Pocket 2 is also by far the best consumer camera for low-light use. The stabilization is also better in comparison to the original Osmo Pocket because it is always easier to stabilize a wider focal length. That is especially important for walking. Much like with the Action 2, some people would like it to have an interchangeable battery, integrated wireless features and so on. I think that it is crucial to keep the pocket really pocketable, so I like it exactly as it is. If you need to enhance the capabilities of your pocket too, there is a wide variety of accessories which can give you more creative options. Overall, I am very happy with the Pocket 2 and it is still one of my most favorite cameras regardless of category. Insta360 ONE R has been on the market for some time, but it keeps getting better with firmware updates, including the last one. It is a modular camera system and an interesting alternative to traditional action cameras. You can choose one of the three modes that provide different type of footage. 1-inch mode is the most impressive. It can shoot really nice 5.3K footage with very wide field of view and still the best low light performance in the class. 360 mode can turn it into a 360 camera. The footage will look similar to Insta360 ONE X. 4K mode is good for all-round GoPro style use and it provides output similar to GoPro Hero 8. The latest firmware update has significantly improved the in-camera stabilization, which is available up to 4K. It also seems that the colors are more accurate after the latest firmware update. Of course, you can still use the Pro mode and apply the excellent flow state stabilization in the post-production. Now it is also possible to connect it to a smartphone using a cable, which was my favorite feature with the original ONE X, and now it is back. Insta360 has introduced this new SD card quick reader that you can plug into the USB-C port on the camera and then directly to your smartphone. The main compromise of the modular system is the small screen. On the other hand, it allows you to use much larger battery. I think that ONE R is still a very relevant camera, especially for those who can take advantage of the modular system and some unique accessories which are a big part of ONE R ecosystem. Two more budget-friendly cameras that I can still recommend are GoPro Hero 8 and DJI Osmo Action. I actually recommend GoPro Hero 8 over the Hero 9. It uses a normal 12-megapixel 1/2.3-inch sensor and it simply shoots a nice action camera video with good amount of detail and really nice colors. It is also much smaller than Hero 9 and Hero 10. Hero 8 also has great stabilization, which is not that different from newer GoPros in real-world use. The main disadvantage of Hero 8 in comparison to Hero 9 and 10 are both displays. The front screen on Hero 8 is just the old monochrome status display. The back screen is the old 2-inch screen. It is still usable, but some action cameras have much better screens. Overall, I think that the Hero 8 is still a very good action camera and it most likely does everything that you need, so I can definitely recommend it in 2021. DJI Osmo Action is still a solid action camera. It is very well made, it has really good output from 1/2.3-inch 12-megapixel sensor, the best display, and a lot of innovative features. Most importantly, the price is really good at the moment. Osmo Action has received a couple of firmware updates which fix some of the issues. The biggest issue with the Osmo Action was the screen lag associated with rocksteady stabilization. That has been improved by firmware updates, but it is still visible. That might be annoying for certain types of shooting. Forward-facing screen is also nice to have, and I appreciate the option to just unscrew the lens and replace it with a filter. I also think that the DJI Mimo app is the best action camera app together with Insta360 app, and I appreciate that I can use the same app with Pocket 2 and Action 2. Overall, I think that the Osmo Action is a good choice if you kind of want to stay in DJI ecosystem, save some money and still get very good output. We will stay with DJI for a while because I still recommend the original Osmo Pocket. The reason for that is the combination of the focal length, gimbal and image quality, which is still unique. Despite that, I like the Pocket 2 a lot and I think that it is a better device overall. If you mainly want to use narrower field of view, Osmo Pocket 1 is still a great choice. That 26mm focal length is actually the reason why the whole category of pocket gimbal exists. Gimbal is more efficient at that focal length and it doesn't require cropping. Regarding the compact cameras, nothing has really changed and the only two compact cameras that I recommend at the moment are Sony ZV-1 and Sony RX107. ZV1 was basically made to match the needs of modern content creators. It combines the latest 1-inch sensor with 24-70mm equivalent f1.8 to 2.8 lens. The whole package is extremely small. It also adds the rotating screen, which I don't like of course, but the target customers will probably appreciate that. The image quality is very good thanks to that very modern 20-megapixel backside illuminated 1-inch sensor. This sensor has a very solid dynamic range and reasonable low light performance. Importantly, the autofocus on ZV-1 is basically perfect. It is extremely fast, accurate and smooth. The image stabilization generally works well, but it doesn't work that great for vlogging in-your-face type of shots. The battery life is similar to other 1-inch cameras and the user interface feels quite outdated in 2021. Unfortunately, it uses micro USB. Despite that, I think that the ZV-1 is currently the best compact 1-inch sensor camera on the market, even for non-vloggers. An alternative is Sony RX100-7. This is a more premium compact camera with 28-200mm equivalent lens. It also has a viewfinder and tilting screen, which I personally prefer. The rest of the specs are very similar to ZV-1. Having that kind of focal range in such a small package is definitely appealing. Of course, you can't expect G Master optical performance at that size, but the image quality is better than I would expect. If you are looking for that kind of focal range, RX100-7 is definitely a valid alternative to ZV-1. A specific category are 360 cameras. The choice in this class is still pretty easy, and it is Insta360 ONE X2. 360 cameras offer some creative options that are not available with any other camera. First of all, they shoot everything at the same time, so you don't have to worry about the composition. If you shoot for multiple platforms, you can also use the same file for horizontal and vertical video. Insta360 ONE X2 provides basically perfect stitching. 360 video also provides infinite space for digital stabilization. Insta360 ONE S2 actually has the best stabilization that I have ever seen in any camera. It is also very well made and the user interface was greatly improved by the addition of a color touchscreen. The main limitation of this class of 360 cameras is the image quality. It is good enough for Instagram or mixing with 1080p DSLR footage, but it lags behind other cameras on this list. The last device that I will mention is iPhone 13 Pro. Apple has finally put a large 1/1.65-inch type sensor in a smaller 6.1-inch iPhone. The images indeed show more real detail, which means that the iPhone doesn't have to use that much sharpening and computational magic. The amount of detail is really good by smartphone standards. The ultrawide camera is also much better. It uses the same 1/3.4-inch sensor, but the lens is new. It has an f1.8 aperture, it is much better optically, and it produces very nice images. On the other hand, the telephoto camera is a downgrade in my opinion. It also uses 1/3.4-inch sensor, but the f2.8 lens is actually darker than the f2 lens on the 12 Pro. The focal length has also changed from 52-77mm, which is in my opinion less versatile focal length. A huge strength of iPhones is the Pro RAW. Those stacked RAWs capture incredible amount of information and provide huge flexibility. Video also continues to be a big strength of iPhones. Also worth mentioning is the stabilization, which is basically on par with the best action cameras such as the Hero 10 or Action 2. I also really like the rest of iPhone 13 Pro. The display with a smaller notch looks great, A15 SoC has tons of processing power, and the build quality is outstanding. So these were, in my opinion, the best consumer/action cameras available in late 2021. The three that stand out in my opinion are GoPro Hero 10 Black, DJI Pocket 2, and DJI Action 2. Hero 10 Black has basically fixed most of traditional GoPro issues, it is a very solid high-end action camera and it provides great output. DJI Pocket 2 combines 20mm focal length, gimbal stabilization, and outstanding image quality in a package that can indeed fit into a pocket. It is simple to use, the gimbal gives you a lot of creative options, and there is no need to set it up like a smartphone gimbal. Action 2 is the most innovative action or pocket camera of the year. The size to performance ratio is off the charts, it is very well made, and it can provide great creative options to those who can take advantage of that semi-modular design. The size to performance ratio is off the charts, it is very well made, and it can provide great creative options to those who can take advantage of that semi-modular design. So that's it for this video, thank you for watching, I hope that you liked this video and that you found it to be useful. Stay tuned for more videos and maybe consider subscribing if you don't want to miss my future content. I appreciate your feedback in form of thumbs up or thumbs down. If you would like to ask anything or share opinion, please do so in the comment section, and see you next time.